Hey, you got time for a beer? I think I do. It's New Brew Thursday, or we'll be here shortly. Today I have Scarlet Dawn IPA. It's a session red India pale ale from Founders Brewery, or Founders Brewing, out of Grand Rapids. Let's see what else it has on here. Crack it, pour it, love it. Government warning. 5.1% alcohol by volume. 45 IBUs. 12 ounces. Founders Brewing Company, Grand Rapids, Michigan. Drink responsibly. They don't serve Founders in the clink. I always wondered what responsibly tasted like. Because it's a great shirt. From a great university. All right. So, red IPA, which means I'm expecting it to be red-ish. I mean, like, you know, like Killian's red, because that's how the malt looks. It's not going to be like the color of the can here. Should be a little bit darker than a regular ale. Which, there it is. Oh yeah, lots of head. Which completely changes the taste of the beer from what I've been told. It's actually a thing. You can order beer that's poured like all head, but you got to do it on tap because it's hard to get it to do that. And you're supposed to shoot it, really. Like just drink it all in one go because, I mean, there's like nothing there. It's all head. So it should be a little bit malty, a little bit darker, and what else? IPA, so hoppy would be my expectation. Should be pretty good, if I remember right, it is. Smells kind of grapefruity. Cool. Tastes like a West Coast IPA, so awesome. Not an East Coast IPA. I like that. I do appreciate a good West Coast IPA more so than the East Coast ones because they're always so stinking sweet. I want my hops to taste bitter, like my soul. It's bitter. It's good. I like it a lot. Malty on the back end. I'd like to say cracker, but really there's not, it'd be a pretty burnt up cracker if that's what it was. It's pretty good. That was a strange flavor. I doubt that's what the flavor that I'm thinking that I'm getting, I don't think it's really what I'm getting, but I'm not going to share that with you because the flavor that I think I'm getting is kind of more of a smell that I've smelled before, and it's not a pleasant one, but this one wasn't bad. Kind of like meat, which is fine, but it might not be from the beer. It might be from something that's just still stuck, like behind my wisdom teeth or something like that. So there's that. Let's see what else. Still going. Good deal. Duo's trying to get me to do French lessons. And I don't do those on my days off, which includes the day after I get off. Usually I do them before bed, which includes the day that I usually go back. Like I'm off for the day and I don't do it that day. And then the day that I have off, I don't do it then either. So sometimes it's a lot longer, but just by streak freezes and no big deal. And I've got enough of those, so we're good. What kind of beer does this remind me of? Actually, it reminds me a lot of the All Day IPA. It's a little bit heavier than that, but not by much. It doesn't taste heavier than that. It definitely tastes darker than that. The malt's more pronounced in this one than the hops, which with it being red, I would hope that it would be like that because the red is the special thing and not the hops. saw the Scarlet Dawn thing, it reminded me of a trip that I took, springtime, like beginning of springtime, like this is fall, like last spring, I drove to Port Austin over on Lake Huron and watched the sun come up over Canada. Well, I mean, over the lake, but could definitely see windmills in the sunrise over on the lake, which was very cool. Very cool. I like that a lot. Some good pictures for Tinder and whatnot. Although there's one that I look old. I hadn't had my hair cut in a little bit, so it was long. And when my hair is long, and with that bright sunshine on my face, like, everything looked white. And not that it doesn't really look white now that my hair is cut, but I think it looks less so. I'm like probably about 10 years younger when I get my hair cut. But I've had like the same hairstyle for 20 years anyway. No, not 20 years. 2006. So, I mean, it's coming up close. It's like 15 years. But yeah, so drove over there super early in the morning, drove back. I was back here by like 10 o'clock. Nobody even realized that I went until I posted pictures on Facebook. I thought it was funny, but they didn't. They're just like, why is he so tired? Because I'd been up for like 6 more hours than what they thought I'd been up. Because that's how long it took me to get back here. I bought a bunch of crap at Meijer that I couldn't find at my Meijer, which was nice because there's stuff that I was looking for, vitamins and shampoo and stuff like that. So that was good too. Beer, got some beer, Sour Monkey, something like that. Pretty good stuff. I like that one. I like sour beers, though, in general. And happy beers, those are good, too. Any other beers? Kind of reminds, this one, oh man, the coloring, too. Does this or does this not look a lot like a Two-Hearted? Oh, it looks a lot like a Two-Hearted. This one doesn't taste as heavy as a Two-Hearted, though. I don't think. It's been a little bit since I've had one, but it looks a lot like a Two-Hearted, which is cool. Because, well, Founders doesn't make Two-Hearted. That's Bell's. But, yeah, it kind of reminds me of that, too. Which is good, because I like Two-Hearted. If I were going to pick, just because of what Founders has been in the news for. I mean, this wasn't recently, but what they've been in the news for, I would pick Bell's because, I mean, not quite as misogynistic at Bell's, apparently, as at Founders. Or, you know, racist or whatever it is. Founders still makes good beer, so I'm still buying it because I like their beer, even if the people that work there aren't necessarily the greatest people in the world. That's a thing I've got to live with, unfortunately. So I actually got to see somebody about my vertigo, which is kind of interesting. Apparently, I have an inner ear virus, which does this. Usually, well, I mean, the virus can cause hearing loss and vertigo. From what they saw, I don't have much of a hearing loss, but also the pressures in my ears are very different. They look different. So then it's on the left side, which we knew before, kind of. It's on the left side, and it's not great. But apparently within the first 6 weeks, you can take some prednisone. So I start on that tomorrow. So I really shouldn't be drinking for the rest of the week while I'm on that. Maybe I can at the end of the day because it's after it's had it's a chance to work. We'll find out. But so steroids should make this better, faster, which is good. And they said, yeah, it should go away eventually. But apparently hearing loss, if you have hearing loss, which I don't have really from this, hearing loss can stick around like forever. Like if I was 20 or 30 years older than what I am right now, it could be a big problem, and I probably wouldn't get rid of this within my lifetime. But with the right treatment and stuff, I should be able to get rid of it sooner, hopefully. Like, it might only last for 5 years, which would be terrible still, but better than, you know, never going away. Okay, we're getting down to the last little bit here. So, don't forget, you can find me on Untappd, TubaJake_69. Hopefully you're watching this on YouTube, TubaJake_69. I'll put it a link up to it on Twitter, TubaJake_69. And I'll put a link up, and I might post this on Instagram, also at TubaJake_69, in case you're looking for it. Let's see. Just about. I got a quote for you, too, from B.B. King. That jazz guitar player, or blues guitar player. Pretty cool dude. So what B.B. King says, "The beautiful thing about learning is nobody can take it away from you." Which is pretty true. Learning is super important, and you should do as much learning as you can, whenever you can. The more you know, the better. And really, the only person that can take it away from you is you. But usually it's not on purpose. Usually it's like brain trauma that takes it away from you. But after the brain trauma, you can learn again, which would be super cool too. All right, so I'm going to get out of here. Happy to talk with you. I'll see you next time, if you got time for a beer.